There are so many identity product solutions in the industry, such as KeyClock, WSO2IDP, FusionAuth, PingFederate. Also, there exist identity as service solutions like Auth0 and AssureAD as well. Even though there are so many choices, still some developers tend to handle users' identity and access management by themselves. They do it in two ways. Either introduce a few more endpoints for user management and authentication in the same business application they are working on, or build a separate application to manage user identities and authentications. First method is more convenient and popular out of both. Due to the following reasons, it is justifiable that it is convenient to manage identity and access in their own way. The first thing is, identity and access management can be done using few API calls. By creating few CRUD API endpoints, user management and authentication can be done easily with the support of a database table as the user storage. Second reason is, there's nothing new to learn. No need to learn about operating or managing an external identity and access management system. If somebody would pick an external IAM solution, it can be either SaaS or standalone. Certainly, there comes a learning phase as well. Things like user management, integration with the existing applications via a standard protocol like OpenID Connect need to be learned. This hassle can be avoided by using an in-house solution. Due to these reasons, developers might start developing their own IAM systems. In short term, it looks like a good solution, but in the long run, these problems may start to appear one by one. In-house solutions might not be compliant to security standards. Generally, there are certain security standards for identity and access management solutions. One simple standard is, user password should not be stored in plain text. Instead, a hash of it should be stored for later verifications. If your IAM solution is not compliant with these kind of guidelines, that implies it is vulnerable to attacks. Also, some organizations go through various compliance audits to make sure the organization is in compliance with the international standards. Even these audits might fail due to the usage of non-compliant systems for user identity and access management. Less features. As the organization grows, it needs to integrate with so many other business applications. To integrate an organization's application with other external applications, organizations should support standard protocols like OpenID Connect or XAML. Perhaps you might need to enable social logins for user to log in to your system using platforms like Facebook or Google. Developing these features is an in-house application will be a time and money consuming task, but these features are provided inbuilt with the industrial identity and access management systems. Other one is high maintenance cost. Additional dev and QA resources will be required to develop the product and test it. These human resources could have been used to develop your business application for the growth of the organization. What I have explained are a few of the problems you are going to face with an in-house solution. In addition to that, you might be struggling with implementing non-functional requirements such as making the system high available, maintainable and fault tolerant. Now you might be thinking, which method should I select? My personal recommendation is always to use an industrially recognized standard identity and access management system. They come in both standalone and software as a service flavors. It is because security is a very important aspect of a business application and it should be properly implemented from the ground level. But I leave you another option here. Based on the time and budget, available human resources, dev team's knowledge and experience level in IAM, and most importantly, knowing the price you have to pay in case of an IAM infringement, you can temporarily develop and use your own IAM module. But you should keep in mind, this is a technical debt and it is mandatory to migrate into a proper IAM solution in the near future. So that is my second option if you are not using an industrially reputed identity and access management system. I believe you got a clear understanding about the topic. If you have any question about these approaches, please put a comment. I will make sure to get back to you with an answer. See you in the next video. Thank you very much.